Thank you so much for coming out on this rainy and finally cool evening in South Texas. So we thank you all for your attention. I would also like to thank Dr. Roberto Vela Cordova. He is going to be our translator and interpreter tonight, which is tiring work, so we appreciate that. And next, I'm going to turn it over to Dr. Jose Villarreal, who's been our main organizer for this event. So this event would not be happening without his efforts and communications. So thank you, Dr. Villarreal.
Good evening, everybody. Can everybody hear me? Okay. It's good to see everybody here, all the students, all the faculty. I want to thank Texas A&M Kingsville for allowing two parents of the missing 43 to be here tonight. The name of the crusade that these gentlemen are carrying is called Crusade for Truth and Justice. And so it involves the disappearance of 43 students 2 years ago. In September, the anniversary was completed this past September. And so Texas A&M Kingsville, when it was Texas A&I back in the day, this is my alma mater. I'm glad to be here. Texas A&M has a history of activism, has a history of involvement in the community, has a history of caring for our fellow man. And we're so glad to hear to see all these young faces and faculty and adults and everybody here, because we're carrying on the tradition of Texas A&M being involved in the community and international affairs and learning of what's going on in the world. The university is a perfect place to improve and implement our critical thinking. And if a university doesn't allow the freedom of critical thinking, then it's not really meeting its function, because the university is a place of learning. It's a place of learning how to expand our minds to what's really going on in the world. And so we're very fortunate that this university allowed, and I want to thank the sociology, psychology department, political science, history and political science, and philosophy department, and the language and literature departments. Let's give them a big hand, please. So with this crusade of truth and justice, these two men are coming here with a heavy heart, with sadness in their heart, but at the same time with determination and drive to speak the truth of what's really happening in Ayotzinapa and Iguala and what's going on in Mexico. As we know, the social media in Mexico is controlled by the government. We don't hear very much news of what's going on in Mexico across the border. Even the media here in the U.S. has limits on what we hear about this case. And so this case is sort of wants to be put under the table, but these parents have taken it upon themselves to speak up and to tell the world what really happened. And so we see that the political government, the government in Mexico of Ernesto Peña Nieto is corrupt, is influenced by organized crime. And so people are tired. And so on the last march, people are asking, well, is this movement growing, or is this growing, or is this movement going down? I was talking to Mr. Mario here, who's the parent of this young man here, and he said that the last time they had a march in Mexico City, there was over 100,000 people. 100,000 people. That's a lot of folks out in the street demanding justice, not only for these 43 missing students, but for all the other missing people that have disappeared in Mexico, and the government is making no effort to find their whereabouts. The United States government, well, what can we do? We're in the United States. Why should we care about this incident? And the situation is, the reality of the situation is that our government, the United States government, the U.S. Senate, just approved $2.3 billion of aid to Mexico to fight the carteles. And the Senate approved this amount of money again because supposedly Mexico is making improvements in their the way they treat their fellow citizens. Well, we know for a fact that as all the people that are being killed right now in Mexico and disappeared, they have not made any progress as far as treating his fellow citizens. So where is the democracy? Where is the freedom of speech? Journalists are being kidnapped and killed for freedom of expression. These young kids that were here, that are in front of you today, take a good look at them before you go. We're going to have a question and answer period at the end. These were future teachers. These were future educators. These are young men in the same shoes that you're in. They wanted an education. They wanted to teach. They wanted to go out in the poor communities. They were struggling to become teachers, to fight illiteracy, to tell the people of the social conditions of Mexico. And the reason they were kidnapped is because the establishment of Mexico wanted to make an example that whoever raises their voice against their power is going to get punished. The leaders of the movement have stopped negotiating with the Attorney General in Mexico because they get empty promises. Wait, wait, we're going to investigate. Wait means nothing. Wait means they're not going to do nothing. And so these gentlemen are, there's about three teams across the nation. One is going to the East Coast, one is going straight up north, and the other one's going towards California. Teams of parents that want to give out the information, that want to tell the story, the real story of what happened. And so I don't want to take too much time. I'm going to introduce at this time an expert in political affairs of Mexico. And please ask questions at the end of the session. Come and introduce yourself to the parents, to the leaders of this movement. We're very blessed and very fortunate that you guys are here. It makes our heart happy, and it makes us stronger. And like the theme of the caravan, truth and justice will prevail. And at this time, I want to introduce Mr. Richard Hardwig, who is going to say a few words on the violence and situations in Mexico. Thank you.
And just quickly, a couple of logistical notes that I forgot to mention. One, if you could sign our sign-in sheet on the way out, that will keep us in compliance with having ordered food for tonight's event. So I would appreciate it if you all could sign in on your way out. And two, if you haven't silenced your cell phones, please do so. Thank you.
Thank you. Can you hear me?
No, it's not for the room, it's for the stream.
Okay. Yes. My name is Richard Hartwig. I teach political science at the university. Periodically, I teach a course on Mexico, or the last course I taught related to this was a course on drug violence in Colombia and Mexico. Before I came to this university about 23 years ago, I taught for 3 years in Monterrey, at the University of Monterrey, and then 2 years at Monterrey Tech. Mexico, as you know, is a wonderful, wonderful country. You go to Monterrey Tech, and they're more advanced than we are technologically. Magnificent students. I just had an absolutely magnificent time. It was the best 3 years of my life, probably. On the other hand, Mexico has some very serious problems as well. Now, this evening is for the students and for the parents of the students. Mario Cesar Gonzalez Contreras, from Tlaxcala, Mexico, Felipe de la Cruz Sandoval, Acapulco, Mexico. But I'd just like to say a little bit of a background for those of you who aren't too familiar with Mexico. Mexico had a revolution starting in 1910. From 1929 to 2000, it had a very curious form of dictatorship. It had the dictator would change every 6 years. It is an extremely centralized place. The president would come to power, would have 6 years in power, your rotation in power, and then the president would choose the next president from his cabinet. Of course, they were all men. One-party systems tend to be corrupt. Mexico was certainly no exception to this. Mexico has a federal system, a presidential federal system like we do. Only during the reign of the PRI, Partido Revolucionario Institucional, the one party, every president of Mexico from 1929 to 2000 came from the same political party. So competition was simply within the political party. When I was in Mexico, the president could call up the governor of a state who had just been elected for 6 years and say, you're going to resign tomorrow. The person will resign tomorrow. A very centralized system. It was corrupt, but the president could, you know, change things around. If the president decided that this drug gang was getting out of control, he could close them down. Often one drug gang would get information on the other drug gang, and they would close down the other drug gang and say, hey, we're making big progress. But you had corruption in the police, in the military, in the court system, but it was controlled from the center. The center could do something about it if they wanted to in the particular states. In the year 2000, the system broke apart. Vicente Fox of the PAN party, Partido Acción Nacional, the acronym means bread in Spanish, Vicente Fox took over. The PAN had no experience at the national level. They didn't have a cadre of people to keep put in office. So they had to keep a lot of the PRI people there. You ended up with a tremendous power vacuum. And the power vacuum was filled by the people from the drug cartels. Now there was no control. Fox made, I think, a big mistake. He declared war on the cartels without having the strategy or the means of doing anything about it. And you had this fantastic war between the cartels and the Mexican army and the police. Monterrey became very dangerous for several years. Now you can fly into Monterrey and it's pretty good shape, but I wouldn't advise driving. But you had this very serious problem, particularly in the rural areas, of corruption. The narcos, of course, the drug traffickers try to corrupt the whole system, and they've been fairly successful in doing so. One of the strategies that I think that failed in Mexico was they tried to decapitate the drug cartels. And they took out, for example, the leader of the Gulf cartel, and the result was that the Zetas appeared. They had been the enforcement arm of the Gulf cartel. And you would try to decapitate the different drug gangs, they would split apart and the assassins would take over. This was not a great improvement. Anyway, about the 2014 killings that we're talking about here, disappearances in the in Iguala, in the state of Guerrero. Guerrero is a state on the Pacific coast. Acapulco is the largest city. Everybody knows where Acapulco is. My information comes, I just looked up in the on the web an article in the New York Times, April 24th of this year, by Kirk Semple, missing Mexican students suffered a night of terror. Incredibly horrendous description of what happened this particular night. And then I looked up the Wikipedia article, 2014 Iguala mass kidnapping. This article has 212 footnotes. I think it's really quite a comprehensive article. So just a few introductory words about what actually happened. On the night of September 26, 2014, in Iguala, Guerrero, students from the Escuela Normal Rural Raúl Isidro Burgos, it's a teacher's college, they have a tradition of activism in this particular college, and they have a tradition, apparently, of a particular kind of a year. They went to go to an event, and they steal some buses, which they return after the event. Police know that's going to happen, but they don't particularly like it. In this particular event, they were trying to go to Mexico City to celebrate the events of 1968, when the Olympics was held in Mexico City, and the army surrounded a group of very large group of students in the Plaza de Tlatelolco and machine gunned them, killed them, hundreds of students. And the Interior Minister became the next president. I mean, this is power, right? If you can massacre hundreds of students from your national university and nothing happens, nobody goes to jail, this is really something. Now, things have changed a lot in Mexico since then. Anyway, there was the students got these buses, and they were traveling along on these buses, and about 100 of them ended up in this town of Iguala. They were intercepted by the city police, who had been sent by the mayor. The mayor's wife was giving a speech, and they thought that the students wanted to interrupt the speech, and so the mayor sent the police, and the police took the students to the local drug cartel, called Guerreros Unidos, which is split off from the Beltran Leyva gang. Apparently, the Beltran Leyva people thought that they didn't know who these people were. They thought that they threatened their control of the area. So apparently, according to the Wikipedia article, they tortured and burned alive these students, and then made a big deal of burning for hours and hours, burning the bodies. Now, we really don't know exactly what happened. These only maybe very few have been really identified. A bus carrying players from a local soccer team were also fired on. Three people were killed. Two more people were killed when an impromptu news conference in the middle of the road was fired on. 22 police officers were arrested. The mayor and the mayor's wife fled the town. They were later found in Mexico City and arrested. Four members of Guerreros Unidos were arrested. The governor of the state of Guerrero, who was from the PRD party, Partido Revolucionario Democrático, he resigned while he asked Congress for a leave of absence. There's nothing in the story about any convictions. At this point, I would like to turn the evening over to the parents of the parents of the disappeared students. So Mario Cesar Gonzalez Contreras and Felipe de la Cruz Sandoval. I don't know who wants to go first. ¿Quién quiere empezar?
Thank you for your attention. Mr. Mario, his son is pictured here, and so he carries a heavy burden. Please talk to him when he gets through and give him support. And he's a very brave man, just like the other gentleman, to carrying on the movement in Mexico, because it's very dangerous to be speaking out right nowadays. They're targeting activists. Well, it's a great pleasure, and please welcome Mr. Mario Contreras.
Buenas tardes, jóvenes. Se me hace un poco difícil a mí, como siempre lo he dicho, hablar en frente de tanto joven.
It's very difficult for me to, as I've always said, to speak in front of so many young people.
Porque muchos de ustedes tienen la edad aproximada de mi hijo.
Many of you have the approximate age of my child.
Y a veces me pongo a pensar si él estuviera también poniendo tanta atención como la están poniendo ustedes. Es muy difícil, como padre, estar atrás de un micrófono y estar dando información para poder encontrar a su hijo con vida.
It's very difficult as a father to stand behind a microphone and be looking for information to find my son alive.
Pero lo tenemos que hacer. Lo tenemos que hacer porque no nos podemos callar, porque el amor hacia un hijo es grande.
We have to do it, and we have to do it because we cannot be silent, because the love towards the son is immense.
Y no somos diferentes los 43 padres de familia ni los 43 alumnos. Porque cualquier padre de ustedes haría lo mismo que nosotros. Es cierto, hemos caminado muchísimo, los 43 padres de familia, hemos sufrido muchísimo. Pero tenemos que seguirle.
Suffered a lot in this voyage, but we have to continue.
No, para nosotros, los 43 padres de familia, nuestros 43 hijos están en calidad de desaparecidos, porque no nos han demostrado lo contrario ninguna autoridad científicamente.
For all of us, the 43 parents of the families, our 43 students are all right now has disappeared because they haven't shown any proof otherwise.
Ahorita le estaba poniendo atención aquí al señor que dice que hay una guerra contra el narco, contra el narcotráfico.
I was paying attention to what Mr. Hartwig was saying about the war against the narcotraffic cartels.
No puede haber guerra contra el narcotráfico si es un narcogobierno que maneja todo el Estado mexicano, el narco.
There can be no war against traffickers or the narco cartel if it's a narco government that's controlling the state of Mexico.
Porque es impresionante la impunidad, la complicidad y el abuso de las autoridades.
Because the abuse of authority and the impunity is against those authorities is impressive.
También escuché que el presidente de Iguala estaba haciendo un evento y que fueron para allá los muchachos a estropear el evento.
I also heard that the president of Iguala was conducting an event and that the students went there to disrupt that event.
Y eso no es verdad.
But that wasn't what he said, though. He said that they, well, and, but that wasn't the case.
No hubo ningún tal estropear ni boicotear el evento, porque científicamente los horarios no dan. Científicamente los horarios, a como estaban coordinadas el ataque a los 43 normal, a los normalistas, fue simultáneo.
The events, it says that cannot be true because the events do not coordinate chronologically. The attack against the students of the normal school and the events that was that took place in the city of Iguala didn't happen at the same time.
Fue tan coordinado ese ataque cuando fue el primer ataque en Las Palmas, en la Juan N. Álvarez, en el Palacio de Justicia y a los niños de futbolistas de los Avispones Verdes. Fue en el mismo momento.
What was coordinated was the attack against the normalists in Las Palmas and the attack against the football players, el ataque a los
normalistas, a los estudiantes.
Y a los del,
a los de los camión del los futbolistas soccer de Iguala.
So the attack to the students and the attack to the football players from Iguala has happened simultaneously and it was coordinated.
De los cuales dos niños fueron masacrados con armas de alto calibre.
Of which two children were massacred with high caliber weapons.
Ahí se desprendió lo que nosotros sabemos, la impunidad del Estado mexicano, de cómo está coludido con el narcotráfico el Estado mexicano.
From that we learned about the impunity towards the authorities of the Mexican government and how the Mexican government is in collusion with the narcotraffic groups.
Es tal que hay una línea de investigación que no quiere llevar a cabo, que es el trasiego de Iguala a Chicago de droga.
It is such that there's a line of inquiry that the government doesn't want to pursue, which is the traffic of drugs from Iguala to Chicago.
Porque no aparece el famoso quinto camión.
Because the fifth truck does not appear.
Un camión que desapareció la Policía Federal en controversia con el ejército mexicano.
A truck that the federal police
took in
in conjunction with the Mexican army.
Lo cambiaron el camión que presentaron y al chofer.
They switched the truck that they were that they presented, and they switched also the driver that was presented as the fifth of the infamous fifth truck.
Pero eso lo descubrió el equipo de la Interamericana de Derechos Humanos, el GEI.
But that was discovered by the
GEI.
The International Group of Rights. So that rights group was the one that discovered the truck that was put forward as the fifth one.
Es un equipo que afortunadamente llegó para defendernos.
That's a team that fortunately came in to defend our rights.
Porque el Estado mexicano nos los quiso entregar de distintas maneras a esos 43 alumnos.
Because the Mexican state wanted to turn the students in a different way.
La primera vez fue en las fosas, que nos entregaban un pedazo de miembro, de un pedazo de un ser humano, y eso es lo que nos tocaba a cada padre de familia de los 43.
The first time they gave us part of the bodies of human bodies, and each family received a part of the body of the students.
Pero afortunadamente llegó un equipo de antropólogos argentinos que nos empezó a ayudar. La última vez y la más fuerte es cómo explicaron por televisión, porque no tuvieron ni el valor de decírselo primero a los padres.
The last time and the hardest one was the explanation they gave on TV, and the lack of respect at not telling the parents first what the information was.
Si nos lo sacaron por la televisora que siempre apoya al gobierno. A donde describen cómo hincan a nuestros hijos, les pegan un balazo en la cabeza, los tiran a la barranca y les prenden fuego. Esa fue su verdad histórica del gobierno hacia los 43 padres de familia y al pueblo mexicano.
That was the historical truth of the government towards the parents of the 43 and to the Mexican people.
Pero hay una cosa importante, que no nada más el Estado mexicano le está mintiendo a 43 familias, a 43 padres de familia, le está mintiendo a toda una nación.
There's an important thing, which is that the government was not only lying to the families of the 43, they were lying to a whole nation.
Ahí vimos cómo manipularon las pruebas, cómo se juntaron los casquillos debajo de una de los 43 casquillos, cómo aparecieron debajo de una piedra, cómo se juntaron esos casquillos, quién los puso ahí.
Under the rocks that were hidden, and who, and we also find out who put the shells of the bullets under those rocks, and how we found them there.
Y días antes habían ido nuestros expertos a buscar pruebas y nunca vieron esos casquillos.
Days before, our experts had gone to the area to look for proof, and those bullet shells were never seen.
Pero lo más sorprendente fue un día antes de que encontraran el huesito de la prueba de Venancio Mora.
Venancio Mora.
¿Cómo Tomás Herón, el secretario general de la nación, está sembrando. De Segob. Está sembrando las pruebas en el río San Juan.
And how Tomás Gerón, the secretario de...
De la Segob, de Secretaría de Gobernación.
The secretary of government was throwing the evidence, tirando la evidencia al río.
Sí.
Was throwing the evidence into a river.
¿Cómo sacó supuestamente el criminal que quemó a nuestros hijos sin algún permiso, sin ninguna autoridad para llevarlo al río San Juan?
How he took the criminal that burned the bodies with any authority and permission and he took him to the river?
Río San Juan.
And he took him to the río San Juan. So, lo que dice es que llevó al criminal, al que cometió los actos, al río San Juan.
Y lo peor de todo, señores, que hasta dónde llega el cinismo del Estado mexicano, que sacó dos fotografías de dos miembros de la ONU, que supuestamente ellos habían visto cómo habían encontrado las pruebas en el río San Juan.
And the worst is the how they showed the cynism of the government of Mexico. They had taken two pictures of the bodies. And how they had taken them to the Rio San Juan.
De lo cual la ONU el mismo día
and showed them to the United Organization of Nations, the UN.
De lo cual la ONU al otro día desmintió que sus dos miembros activos habían estado con Tomás Herón.
Which the United Nations denied that their two active members that supposedly took the pictures had been there with the secretary Tomás Herón.
Es por eso que los 43 padres de familia andan por donde sea. Es por eso que las actividades que hacemos los 43 padres y madres de familia, andar por todos lados, en cualquier país que nos inviten y que nos paguen como por ejemplo las organizaciones, los colectivos, tenemos que estar ahí.
That's why the 43 parents are everywhere that we can be. That's why whenever we're invited by any nation or we're helped with costs to visit any place by organizations, we will be there telling our stories.
Muchos de ustedes se preguntan, ¿a qué venimos si no sucedió aquí?
Some of you may ask yourselves, why are we here if that didn't happen here?
Pero para nosotros es importantísimo que nos escuchen y vean lo que está pasando en México, que es uno de los cuales la información al exterior del país le hace más efecto al Estado mexicano.
But for us it is important that you understand the information that cannot go out of Mexico and does so much damage to Mexico City by not having any information available.
Por eso la ayuda internacional a los 43 padres es fundamental para que haya verdad y justicia en el primer caso de toda la historia de México.
That's why it's important that we tell our story and so that there be information about the truth and justice case, which is the first one being is the first one in the whole history of Mexico.
Que no quede impune como un Tanguato, un Aguas Blancas, un Acteal, un Oxtitlán, que fueron matanzas y nunca tuvieron justicia ni verdad.
That it doesn't stay as many other massacres, the places he mentioned, matanzas,
Noxtitlán,
Tanguato,
Aguas Blancas, Acteal.
And Acteal, which were never resolved.
Que es por eso que los 43 padres de familia hemos sufrido muchísimo, jóvenes. Pero como no tienen idea, porque hemos caminado kilómetro tras kilómetro y cientos de kilómetros lo hemos hecho. Y hemos viajado miles de kilómetros. Pero él vale la pena hacer lo que estoy haciendo.
So that's why we have traveled so many hundreds and hundreds of miles. Suffered so much in this journey, but he is worth all the traveling and all the stories that I need to come and tell.
Porque lo que yo estoy haciendo, cualquier padre de ustedes lo haría, o tal vez más. Gracias a todos ustedes por escuchar a este viejo herido del corazón en búsqueda de su hijo. Muchas gracias y que Dios los bendiga.
This time I want to introduce Felipe de la Cruz. His son managed to not be escaped during this ambush, and he's a very grassroots leader, both of them, and he has personally met with the President of Mexico, Peña Nieto, and advised Peña Nieto that how could he sleep at night if this issue is not resolved, and that, you know, he's got a lot of courage, this man, both of them, to be here. Please welcome Mr. Felipe de la Cruz.
Buenas noches a todos. Qué bueno que algunos entiendan el español. Para nosotros, el estar aquí con ustedes es una forma de alimentar la esperanza. Como pueden ver, ahí colgamos los rostros de los jóvenes que el gobierno mexicano nos arrebató el 26 y 27 de septiembre del 2014 en Iguala.
As you can see, we have the pictures of the young men that the government of Mexico snatched from us in September 16 and 17 in the city of Iguala.
Llevamos más de 2 años en esta lucha incansable por rescatar de donde quiera que los tenga el gobierno de México, porque son futuros maestros.
We have been in this struggle to find and take back these future teachers from the government of Mexico, wherever they may have them.
El gobierno mexicano, en su sentido de culpabilidad, ha ofrecido a las familias mucho dinero, muchas cosas, amenazas de muerte también a los que estamos en el movimiento. Pero siempre hemos dicho nosotros que si la riqueza para ellos es el dinero, para los mexicanos, para los pobres de nuestro país, el tesoro más grande son nuestros hijos.
The government has made offers, monetary offers to the families to try to dissuade their guilt for what happened. They've even threatened with death some of the families for the activism that we have taken forward. And we've told them that what's most important for us, it's not the money, even though we're poor, it's the life of the children and of our teachers.
No es fácil para nosotros seguir en este movimiento porque siempre encontramos obstáculos, pero no podemos desistir porque tenemos la seguridad de que los vamos a encontrar. Porque a pesar de las mentiras del gobierno mexicano para hacer creer a la sociedad del mundo y de nuestro país de que los jóvenes fueron asesinados en el basurero de Cocula, hoy nosotros podemos decir que le ha mentido al mundo y le ha mentido a los mexicanos.
Even situation of the students in a dumpster in Cocula, we today can say that the government has lied and has lied to the nation and to all the nations of the world.
Científicamente está demostrado que la verdad histórica de Murillo Karam nunca existió, porque es imposible quemar 43 cuerpos en ese lugar, y más cuando fue una noche lluviosa.
It has been scientifically proven that the history told by what was the name, Francisco Cara?
No, Jesús Murillo Cara.
Jesús, by Jesús Murillo Cara, is inconsistent with the fact that that those 43 bodies couldn't be burned in the place that they were burned, in particular because of the night and the rain that fell that night.
Por eso podemos asegurar nosotros que los jóvenes están vivos en algún lugar y que los vamos a rescatar de donde quiera que los tengan.
That's why we are sure that the children are alive and that we're going to rescue them from wherever they may have them.
Para nosotros está claro la intención del gobierno mexicano de desaparecer las escuelas como la escuela normal de Ayotzinapa, porque son formadores de maestros, pero de maestros de conciencia que llevan educación a las comunidades más alejadas de nuestro país.
For us it is clear that the purpose of the government is to eliminate the schools of teachers Yotzinapa, like the school of Yotzinapa, in particular because these schools are developing teachers with conscience about the fact that they're the most marginalized, that they live in the most marginalized parts of Mexico.
Queremos decirles a ustedes que el 4 de octubre, nuevamente la escuela normal de Yotzinapa fue atacada y asesinaron a dos jóvenes estudiantes que estaban por concluir su licenciatura en educación.
We would like to tell you that in the 4th of October, the school of Yotzinapa was again attacked by the government, and two students were killed, two students that were about to graduate in the school as teachers.
Son jóvenes que ya estaban en el cuarto grado, y al regresar de unas prácticas docentes, los atacaron en el tramo de Chilpancingo a la escuela y los ejecutaron de manera cobarde. El gobierno pretende hacer creer que fue un asalto.
These students were students that were in their fourth year about to graduate as teachers. They were traveling from
Chilpancingo a Yotzinapa.
To the school, and they were shut down, gunned down. And the government wants to make us believe that it happened that it was because of an assault of a robber.
Hace unos momentos Don Mario decía que muchos se preguntan, ¿y por qué venimos acá si las cosas pasaron en nuestro país? Queremos decirles que para nosotros es bien importante que el mundo sepa, porque la presión al gobierno mexicano es más fuerte de otros países que la nuestra en México.
So people ask us all the time, why are we coming here to tell the story? And for us it's very important that everybody understands that to put pressure to Mexico from the outside is a lot more, shows a lot more strength than the force that we can show inside of Mexico.
Hoy podemos decirle al mundo que en México hay un presidente que para nosotros es el asesino más grande de la historia moderna en nuestro país.
Today we can say that we have a president that is the biggest assassin in the modern history of our country.
Porque está coludido con la delincuencia organizada y permite que masacren al pueblo de México en la impunidad, en la corrupción. A diario amanecen muertos en nuestro país y ya no son investigadas las causas de los asesinatos Y eso queda claro para nosotros. La corrupción existe.
Because this president and his government is in collusion with the criminal elements of the country and the crimes that that are being committed all around the country and the deaths that are recurring over and over are never investigated and left with impunity against these criminals.
Pero eso está trayendo al pueblo de México la necesidad de organizarse para transformar este sistema de gobierno que día con día nos despoja, viola los derechos humanos y pues nuestros derechos constitucionales con sus reformas estructurales nos está despojando de todos los recursos que existen aún en nuestro país. Y todo eso nos orilla a venir a solicitar el apoyo de todos los habitantes de este lado de Estados Unidos, porque sabemos que la fuerza de ustedes nos ayuda a seguir adelante. De antemano queremos agradecer la presencia de los jóvenes estudiantes, de todos los que están en este lugar. Nosotros siempre hemos dicho que el futuro de la humanidad está en manos de los jóvenes, pero principalmente de los jóvenes que estudian, que se preparan. En México a eso es lo que le tiene miedo el gobierno, a que los jóvenes se preparen. Queremos agradecer al maestro José, al maestro Harvick y a todos ustedes el favor que nos hacen de venir, de escuchar, porque sabemos que esto no va a quedar encerrado en este espacio, sino que va a salir afuera y se va a conocer la situación que vivimos los mexicanos. Muchas gracias.
This is a protest song that I wrote for the Normalistas. Se llama En Defensa de los 43. Ahí les va. I'm going to do the best I can.
Hijo mío, no tengas pendiente, te seguiremos.
Ayotzinapa, no te olvido. Te llevo en mi corazón. Seguiremos luchando por nuestra liberación. En Iguala, Guerrero, es donde sucedió una injusticia muy grande que el gobierno cometió. Cuarenta y tres normalistas el gobierno nos quiere quitar, pero ellos no saben que sigamos a marchar. Lloro lágrimas de coraje, lloro lágrimas de injusticia, porque vivos se los llevaron y vivos los queremos. El gobierno y los carteles es el mismo animal, tenemos que defendernos en contra de lo que está mal. No conocían el miedo ni la intimidación. Todos estaban dispuestos a pelear la corrupción. Ese gobierno tirano lo tenemos que tumbar. Vamos uniendo el pueblo y luchar por libertad. Los llevo en mi corazón, porque ellos empezaron la segunda revolución. Ese gobierno de Nieto lo tenemos que cambiar, porque trae sangre en las manos y nos tiene que pagar. Lloro lágrimas de coraje, lloro lágrimas de injusticia, porque vivos se los llevaron y vivos los queremos. Que viva Lucio Cabañas y Genaro Vázquez también, que vivan los normalistas y sus ideales del bien. Virgen de Guadalupe, ayúdanos a resistir este gobierno asesino que tenemos que combatir. Dios Jesucristo en los cielos, tú que tienes el poder, ayuda a todos los pobres para poder vencer. Hijo mío, no tengas pendiente de seguiré buscando hasta te encuentre. Questions para el señor Felipe y señor Mario.
Hasta ahorita las investigaciones siguen abiertas, pero el gobierno de México tiene tan cerrada la intención de que no se sepa, porque como fueron militares y policías quienes cometieron el crimen, es muy difícil, pero eso no nos hace desistir, sino todo lo contrario, seguir avanzando hasta que sepamos qué pasó ese día. Pues sobre las investigaciones que realizaron los expertos independientes, hay varias líneas de investigación y ahorita la que se está trabajando es la línea de Huitzuco, que es un pueblo cercano a Iguala, en donde se llevaron un grupo de estudiantes para que un personaje que ellos le llamaron el patrón y el caminante, pues decidieran qué hacer con ellos. Entonces, por ahí pudiéramos empezar a caminar la línea de lo que pudo haber pasado con los jóvenes.
The question was if there was any idea what the students may be. The first answer to the question was, the first part of the answer was that the government is not really following any line of investigations because they're closing down due to the fact that the people involved in the assassination were state police, policías del estado, federales, state police and the army. And the second part of the question was if the families knew, had any idea where the students may be. And he said that there's one line of inquiry that's been followed at an adjacent town called Itzalpa, el pueblo, se llama
Huitzuco,
there's a near town called Huitzuco, and it is believed that students might have been taken to that town. There were two characters in this place, excuse me, El Patrón and El Caminante, and that line of inquiry is being followed to see some whereabouts can be found through that inquiry. She's asking if any of the students, while the events happened, try to communicate with the parents about what was going on.
Sí, sí, hay videos que estaban sacando los muchachos, cómo estaban gritando los que no dispararan, que no llevaban armas, que no fueran malos, que ya basta, que habían matado dos, y salieron a la luz, pero después de eso siguieron trabajando los teléfonos de los muchachos 2-3 meses. O sea, los teléfonos se los quitaron los policías y ellos siguieron trabajando, o sea, siguieron agarrando esos teléfonos, de lo cual en la mentira histórica decían que se habían quemado con todo y teléfonos y todo y pertenencias. Es otra línea de investigación en las sábanas de los teléfonos.
So there was communication with the students. They tried to communicate. There were some videos that came out. Where the students are screaming and telling the people that had guns to not shoot, that they were unarmed, that it weren't bad people or anything. And then the phones actually kept working 2 meses después.
Three
months after the events had taken place, the phones were still working. The official story, the historical lie, he said, the historical lie told by the government is that everything that the students had been burned with the bodies of the students, and that doesn't coincide with the fact that these phones were still working 3 months out. One of she's asking that one of them mentioned that the government was trying to make concessions with the families, with them, and she's asking what concessions were being tried to do.
Mira.
Did they want you guys to shut up or what contracts or something?
Lo que pasa, que él quería ya cerrar el caso, por lo cual nos ofreció dinero, nos ofreció distintas cosas, carros, camionetas a mis compañeros, porque hay una cosa también en contra mía, que yo soy del estado de Tlaxcala a 9 horas o 10 horas del estado de Guerrero. Yo me hago 10 horas para llegar al estado de Guerrero. Entonces, pero no aceptamos ningún quinto, ni mucho menos, porque ¿cómo puede uno vender a los hijos? ¿O cómo el papá se puede comprar una camioneta con el vientre del hijo? No me cabe en la cabeza que ningún padre lo haría.
The government offered us money, and they offered some of us trucks. My story is that I actually live in 10 hours from Guerrero, in a nearby state, the state of Tlaxcala. And so they were offering these different things so that the investigation would be closed. But the fact is that we didn't take 1 cent from the government. How could we exchange a truck for the lives of our children? Have you received any threats from the president or organized crime?
Sí, yo soy uno de los papás que ha recibido mucho más amenazas. ¿El por qué? Porque soy el que más me muevo, porque soy el que más quiere a su hijo, porque soy el que más grita. Entonces, y de los voceros, pues todos, de los voceros, de los licenciados, todos han recibido amenazas del crimen organizado. Tanto que a mí me hackearon una llamada y la manipularon a favor del Estado. Que ahora yo pertenecía yo al crimen organizado que se había llevado a mi hijo.
Yes, there have been many threats. I'm actually one of the ones that have been threatened the most, possibly because I'm the one that's moving the most and screaming the loudest. There was also a case where there's also the case of parents from El Vocero, from the Vocero, like the newspaper. There's a newspaper called El Vocero, and their parents are organized in the newspaper that have also been threatened. In one case, there was a phone call was recorded of me that was doctored to make me look like I was part of the organized crime organizations.
Ustedes están contando su historia, cuál es el propósito que ustedes quieren sacar de estos viajes que ustedes están contando.
Bueno, lo mencionábamos en la información. ¿Cuál es la intención de estar aquí con ustedes? Primero que nada, que sepan la realidad que vivimos como padres de familia desde hace 2 años.
So we wanted to tell you the as we said before. The reason why we've been here, and the first thing is that, you know, the reality that we live as parents of these families.
Porque los medios de comunicación en México están controlados y deforman la información. Entonces, ellos hicieron creer, primero, la verdad histórica de que ahí se cerraba el caso y los muchachos estaban muertos.
So, the media communication is controlling all aspects of information regarding this case in Mexico, and they want the people to believe that the so-called truth that they said that this case was closed and done with the death of the students was the end of the case.
Y lo más importante para nosotros, cada 26 de cada mes en México, los padres de familia hacemos una movilización grande, porque fue un 26 de septiembre cuando se llevaron a los jóvenes. Entonces, es el apoyo que solicitamos a quienes sientan, ¿verdad?, de ese dolor, la injusticia de lo que se comete en México, para que ese 26 o los 26, con una pancarta que ustedes saquen, al gobierno de México le pesa el ver que otros países siguen exigiendo la presentación con vida de los jóvenes que se llevó el Estado en nuestro país. Y eso es lo más importante.
The most important thing, though, is that every 26th date of the month, we organize manifestations to ask the government about the truth of what happened and where our children are. And it is so important for us that you also make people also outside of Mexico make manifestations today of 26th in solidarity with us. Signs in remembrance of this story is seen by Mexico as a huge pressure from outside entities in Mexico. For the government of Mexico. And that's the most important thing for us.
There was a documentary released in the United States last year called Era por Vivir, Watching Them Die, and it suggested that the Mexican army played an outside role in the disappearance of these students. I was curious if these gentlemen have seen that documentary, what they think about it, and whether they have
el año pasado un documental de Mirar Morir, que dice que el gobierno, el ejército de México tuvo una participación un poco exterior, ¿verdad? No. Y él quería saber que ustedes, si han visto el documental, que es un estilo.
Sí, mire, el documental
Mirar
Morir, es un poco apegado a la realidad. Lo que sí es cierto es que el ejército mexicano actuó de manera directa. Desde el inicio lo hemos denunciado, pero como es parte del gobierno de México, lo siguen protegiendo. No permiten que se investiguen a los soldados. Pero de que es real que participó el ejército mexicano, para nosotros, ellos saben dónde están porque ellos se los llevaron.
Okay, so he's saying that the documentary does tell a lot of truths about what happened, but what there's no doubt about, and what is certainly the truth, is that the government, the military government, the military of Mexico had direct involvement in what was happening and what happened to the students in the city.
Escaparon varios, porque no nada más eran 43, 45. No, fue una academia completa de primer año, o sea, que llevaban apenas un mes, 10 días. Mi hijo acababa de llegar, un mes, 10 días, y iban dos camiones, iban más o menos como 100, o sea, la academia de primero, y de los cuales 43 son de los desaparecidos, dos caídos y tres heridos, inclusive uno está en estado de coma y el otro no tiene mandíbula. O sea, le pegaron los balazos en la cara y el otro está en estado de coma y el otro también está grave de la mano.
So he's saying that
she asked if she had heard that one of the students had actually escaped. Then he said that that did happen, but it's because there was a larger group of students that went in these two buses. And then there were, of those students, 43 were kidnapped, and they don't know the whereabouts. Two were shot and killed, and three were injured by shootings. One has is alive, just have injured in the wrist. One has lost his jaw from the gunshot, and one is currently in a state of coma. So she's asking the mayor of the city of Iguala and the wife of the mayor of the city of Iguala, which were mentioned. So what happened to them since then, and what's going on with the government structure of the city there in Iguala?
Están detenidos los dos, pero no están consignados por la desaparición forzada de los jóvenes. Están consignados por delincuencia organizada y por el crimen de un líder social de ahí de Iguala. Pero ellos están en la cárcel.
They're both in jail. They've been arrested, but not for the crimes committed against the students. They're arrested for some social crime that took place there, for organized crime, por crimen organizado, for organized crime and money laundering. That's me. There is another newspaper or media that has a more truthful story.
Sí, mira, desgraciadamente las dos televisoras que tenemos ahí en México, las más fuertes, por no decir nombres, pues están con ellos, o sea, pagan una cierta cantidad para sacarlos después a favor de ellos. Lo que nos mantiene nosotros con la información y que nos está ayudando, no ayudando, sino que diciendo la verdad, que es lo que queremos nosotros los padres de familia, la verdad. Son los medios alternativos y los medios independientes. Son los que juegan un papel muy importante alrededor del caso de Ayotzinapa.
There are two main TV channels in Mexico, and they both show the version of the state. But we need to find the truth. We rely on alternative media and independent media from the area.
And ¿creen que la revista Proceso y los reporteros sean los más congruentes con la historia o no?
Mira, ha trabajado muy bien y o sea, ha dicho la verdad. Una de las cuales también es Aristegui, que también está muy fuerte en decir la verdad, esa no se queda callada para nada, y es una mujer muy valiente, que también dice la verdad, o sea, no es lo que nosotros, no dice lo que nosotros queramos, sino que dice lo que es.
He's asking if there's la revista se llama, ¿verdad? The reporters from the journal El Proceso is telling a truth story, and they say he answers that yes, that it is one of the journals that's more consequent with the truth. And there's also a reporter, Aristiaga, Aristegui, who is, he characterized her as very brave for keeping up with the truth of the story.
Sí, mira, para ampliar un poco, los medios alternativos que dicen la verdad, que no están sometidos al control del gobierno, hay varios. Está Proceso, está La Jornada, en Guerrero está El Sur, las redes sociales, que es lo que más se difunde y lo que más avanza. Y Desinformemos también, hay una revista que se llama así en México, y eso es lo que hasta hoy nos ha mantenido también informándole a la mayor parte de la sociedad, y eso ha hecho que ya no crean en Televisa ni en TV Azteca. Yo sí los nombro porque son las televisoras que más daño le han hecho a nuestro país, y que bueno, no podemos, al menos yo no puedo ocultar ¿Por qué? Porque son las que nos han lastimado, ¿verdad? Al pueblo de México y a los padres de familia.
So before he even mentioned the names of the TV channels, he just said Media Network. He says that there's some really important journals that I have kept up with the Truth, La Jornada, El Sur, La Jornada del Sur,
Desinformemos, las redes sociales,
and in particular social media. But he also said I will mention the names of those two channels, Televisa and
Tevesteca,
which have been negligent in providing information about the situation, and they need to be called upon. She's asking about a video that was an entrevista. Una entrevista.
Una reunión que tuvimos con él.
Oh, it was a meeting that they had with the president. She's asking a question that was asked, but they couldn't hear. In the video, you cannot hear what the president says, and she's asking if you can relay what he said.
Después del reclamo y de la exigencia que hicimos en la primera reunión con Enrique Peña Nieto, pues le exigíamos respuesta inmediata, y si no tenía la capacidad para darnos respuesta, que renunciara. Y él lo único que nos pidió en esa ocasión era un poquito de confianza, que confiáramos en él y que topara con quien topara, íbamos a dar con los jóvenes y se iba a castigar a los responsables.
So,
llevamos dos años y no hay nada aún todavía.
So we had a meeting with Enrique Nieto, which we were demanding the truth of what he knew about the truth, and if he didn't know, if you can provide information immediately about what happened, that he needed to renounce his position. What he asked from us was a little bit of trust, un poco de confianza, and that they would, the government will find the culprits and will take them to justice. She's asking how did the parents of find out about what happened.
Bueno, yo te puedo decir cómo me enteré yo como padre de familia.
I can tell you how I found out.
Mi hijo y yo tenemos la costumbre de hablarnos por teléfono tres veces al día.
My son and I used to talk to each other three times a week.
Tanto que el día 26 de septiembre, el mero día, eran las 5:35 cuando fue la última llamada.
This was the case so much that the day it even happened, the last call we had was at 5:35 the day that event took place.
Fue la última vez que escuché su voz.
Was the last time I heard his voice.
Me dijo que después me llamaba porque iba a hacer una tarea.
He told me he would call me later because he was going to do some homework.
Nos despedimos y quedamos de hablarnos más tarde.
He said goodbye and we decided to talk a little bit later.
No, ya no me habló.
He didn't
ya no me habló, le hablé por teléfono a la una, a las tres, a las cuatro, a las cinco.
He didn't call me and I called him at one, at two, at three, at four, at five.
Y un amigo de él,
yo
creo que le dio el teléfono, mi número telefónico, no sé, y me hablaron por teléfono a las 9:12 del día 27 de septiembre.
A friend of his who they have given him my number gave me a call the 27th of September at 9:12 in the evening.
Nos avisan que había detenidos, muertos, heridos.
They told us that they were detained, that they were deaths, that they were injured.
Y automáticamente mi esposa y yo nos fuimos para allá.
Immediately my wife and I went over there.
Llegamos a las, fueron como 11:15 de la noche.
It was about 11:15 at night.
cuando llegamos a Ayotzinapa y veíamos que había muchísima gente corriendo y entraban y salían camiones.
And when we got to Ayotzinapa, we saw a lot of people coming in and out in trucks.
Mi esposa y yo nos quedamos ahí en el zaguán para parar los camiones y ver cómo bajaban los alumnos, para ver si bajaba a mí.
So my wife, well, my wife and I stayed in the outskirts waiting for the trucks to come out and seeing the students that came out of the trucks waiting to see our son.
Pero desgraciadamente no bajó.
But sadly he didn't come out.
Y de ahí no nos hemos movido de la escuela desde Ayotzinapa, ahí vivimos, vendimos todo.
Since then we sold everything and we moved near the escuela of Ayotzinapa.
Vendimos todo, nos tuvimos que ir para allá y seguir buscando a nuestro hijo.
And we continued to look for our son.
Pero, como dice el profe, los tenemos que encontrar. Y es una tristeza que mandes o él, porque él estaba estudiando Derecho en la Universidad Autónoma de Puebla. Ya llevaba un semestre para licenciado en Derecho.
Like was mentioned before, we went there because we had to find him. We had to find him particularly because he was studying human rights law in the school, and we feel that it is important that we continue.
Y me dejó la escuela por irse a Ayotzinapa. Me dejó esa escuela por irse a la normal.
Él estaba en la escuela de derechos a Ayotzinapa.
Sí.
So he was in law school, and then he left that law school to go to Ayotzinapa to study to be a teacher.
Pues ahora somos los que nosotros estamos en la escuela y él no.
Now we're the ones that are in the school and not he.
Pero no podemos salirnos de la escuela porque mi esposa y yo pensamos que algún día va a bajar esas escaleras corriendo.
We cannot leave the school, we live there. We cannot leave the school because my wife and I are just waiting one day to see him coming down the stairs running towards us.
Y que lo vamos a volver a abrazar.
And we're going to hug him one more time.
Así es. Yes. Así es como nos enteramos.
That's how we found out. De contarnos la historia y decirnos cómo se les ha sentido todo eso, qué es lo que ustedes quieren que nosotros hagamos, qué podemos hacer nosotros para ayudarnos. Ya sea organizadamente como un grupo o qué.
Híjole, ¿qué podrían hacer?
Sí.
¿Qué podrían hacer? Pues ya están haciendo mucho al escucharnos. Ya es fenomenal que nos estén escuchando.
Listening
pero,
to us is just
como dijo el profe hace un rato, con una cartulina, con un video que suban a las redes pidiendo, exigiendo a los 43, para nosotros es muy importante eso, porque todos los países que hemos estado, afortunadamente, la gente se ha solidarizado mucho con nosotros. Y más que nada que por primera vez haya justicia en México en algún caso, en este caso, o en algún caso, porque nunca había habido justicia.
So, and he said, listening to us is already something that's amazing that you're doing. But like the professor said, he's calling him the professor. Like the professor said, it is also possible to show up with signs to pressure the government of Mexico and to use social media to continue pressuring the government of Mexico from outside in order to try to find justice for not just for this case, but for any case of injustice in disappearance of crimes in Mexico, which have never been resolved. He's asking if because of the threats from the government, if they have to move from where they live or.
No, mira, sí nos han amenazado de muerte, de muchas formas, pero eso no nos intimida.
We're not intimidated by all the death threats that we have received.
Sino todo lo contrario, nos llena de ira y de coraje, de ver cómo quien debe de protegernos pretende seguir haciéndonos daño.
On the contrary, it fills us with courage by the fact that who pretends to actually help us is actually continuing to hurt us. You all mentioned that the 26th of every month there's this a manifestation in Mexico. I would like to know what could we do also the 26th at a national level, if possible, to organize in solidarity with the events that are taking place in Mexico.
Mira, es bien importante. Ya aquí en Estados Unidos hay varios colectivos que cada 26 se manifiestan. Se organizan, van a los consulados y ahí al consulado mexicano le exigen la presentación con vida de los jóvenes. ¿Cómo pueden ustedes ayudarnos? Lo mencionábamos hace rato, ¿no? La organización para que ese día que nosotros nos movilizamos en México, aquí en Estados Unidos crezca esa protesta de exigencia, de justicia en nuestro país. Y decía don Mario, otra forma de podernos ayudar, hacer un video, subirlo a las redes, que es lo que más le pega en México, y de esa manera también pueden ayudarnos mucho, porque ahorita en México hay una situación bien, bien importante para nosotros, ¿sí? Que ya todo México está despertando y se está organizando.
Every month already in the United States, there are collectives that are participating in solidarity with the manifestations we're organizing in Mexico. And these collectives, usually they will go to the Mexican embassies in the region and ask, demand proof of the life of the students. And as Mario has said also before, we would also like to have a social media presence coming from the United States, videos, pictures, anything, because it is very popular in Mexico. It's a way of communication that's very active in Mexico, and it also continues an organization that's already taking place in Mexico around this issue, and it's rising up.
Nada más.
One more question, yes. So how have you protected yourself since the government, which is supposed to be taking care of you, is the one that's attacking you?
No, mira, lo que pasa es que si se tienen que protegernos, pero no lo hacen. Nosotros nos hemos enfrentado y así se lo digo, esos 43 indígenas hemos querido tratar de entrar al cuartel. Nos hemos golpeado a mano limpia con los soldados, y de los cuales pues nos salen chingando porque ellos tienen armas. So. Pero también una cosa bien importante, que pues nosotros no tenemos que dejarnos, porque estamos en una lucha digna, que tenemos que encontrar a esos chamacos. No sé cómo ni cuándo, pero tenemos que encontrarlos. No nos importa si nos van a reprimir, no, o nos golpean de nuevo, no nos importa.
So yeah, they're supposed to protect us. They don't, and we actually organize ourselves, and we go to the cuarteles, the police headquarters, and the state places, and we demand us 43 indigenous people. We go there and we demand proof of life of our children, and of course they have guns and they have the power, so we end up being fucked up by them. That's what everybody left. And then but for us it's very important that we continue to demand proof of life from the state.
If anybody's interested in more information, if you can give me your name and email address, I will take it down and we can organize something here. And I want to close with a little food for thought. The United States has the most powerful intelligence agency in the world. And so we also have to look at our government and the role that they're playing in this investigation. Entonces, if they can go overseas to the Middle East and find Bin Laden, if they can go to Mexico and find El Chapo and the other cartel leaders, why hasn't all the hundreds of DEA agents and FBI agents and CIA agents that our country has in Mexico haven't done any effort to find these young men that went missing? Do you think the United States for 1 minute does not know or has a clue where these young men are? Let's be realistic. Let's use our common sense. Our government is in cahoots with Mexico, with Peña Nieto. We need to put pressure on the Senate to stop sending money over there, because instead of going after the carteles and cartel leaders, they're killing activists. So, food for thought. Again, thank you for everybody that came. You guys are beautiful. Please come and feel the community.